50%, and women education is less than 50% in most of the areas. And the reason for this is child dropouts. By 8th standard, it is 25% of children are getting dropped out, and 9th and 10th, it is reaching to 50% of child dropouts, and most of them are girls. And for the reason for this girl child dropouts is the lack of toilet facility, lack of midday meals, lack of sanitary napkin, child marriages. In this 21st century, you talk about 3G, 4G and 5G. The basic amenity of a girl in her daily life is a toilet. We are thinking of constructing now after 72 years of independence. Even now, if you construct 6 out of 10 lakh water, child marriages. UNICEF declared 40% of child marriage across the globe are from India. And UNICEF declared it would take another 50 more years for India to eradicate this child marriage. When you talk about maternal health, women health, maternal health and iron deficiency, anemia and malnutrition, even after 72 years of independence, a small iron deficiency, we could not overcome that. And India tops the maternal mortality rate. When you talk about women employment, why women are paid 30% less than the men? And only 4% of women are in the organized sector in India when compared to with China, where 85% of women are in workforce. That is the reason why our GDP is just 2.8 trillion compared to China, which is 14.6 trillion. Such a vast difference in GDP. How can you expect our economy to build when half of the population are still lagging behind? So why I'm emphasizing some of these issues here? Even after many initiatives taken by the government in all these 72 years, still we see so much of violence in this thing, because the poor participation of women in politics is the main reason. Even though we contribute to 50% of the population, women contribution in parliament is just 11%. It is less than 10%, that is 7 to 8% in assemblies. So in order to increase this participation, from 11% to 50% of the participation, which is our right, National Women's Party has been launched to increase this participation of women from 11% to 50%. National Women's Party with the tagline, Party of Mothers. You, me, you, everyone are from her. So we had an equal representation in our party also. Like we have 50% women and 50% men. So exactly 2 months back, in the same press club, I have launched this party in 2 months back. The first question raised by for me on that day is, Madam, you can't expect two women to be jointly together. How can you expect 66 crores of women to be on one platform? So I want just proudly want to say, not just the individuals. We have the alliance with the political party, that is the All Indian Women United Party. So I want proudly to say, not just the individuals, even the women political parties have come up together to amplify women's voice. So this is a perfect example for women unity. And across these 2 months, I've been visiting each state and we have launched a party in each state. Like we have visited Tamil Nadu, Karnataka, Kerala, Maharashtra, Madhya Pradesh, Rajasthan, Gujarat, Delhi. So next we are going to North and Northeast state. So I would say I have received tremendous response wherever we visited the states. I could say that everybody is waiting for this moment, for this political platform to be there for women. So that's a beautiful response I got. And I can say we have received 10 lakh members in a span of 2 months after the launch of this party. This is how the tremendous response we are getting. And I want to say even men are supporting our party, that is more appreciable, which is motivating us to move forward ahead.